What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel and welcome to North D.C. We are the Great Barracudas and we represent District of Columbia. That's right, Washington, D.C. It's a city, I guess you could say it's a state, but hey, it is what it is. That's where we reside. This is where we play our football. We are right at the border of D.C. because we are high up in the north of D.C. Anyways, man, we are the Great Barracudas. I think that's a fabulous name. And we are a smash mouth team type, which means we're probably better than what we are used to on this here channel. We will be playing in a dome for the first time on this channel. We did do it for Hawaii A&M, but that series lasted like 3 weeks or whatever it is. And we are called the Fishbowl because we are Barracudas. That's the generic name that gets to your stadium, and I just feel like it worked. I couldn't think of anything but Great Barracudas. I thought of that, and I thought that was awesome. Anyways, well, we were playing in a dome stadium, and here go our uniforms. It's kind of Buccaneers, old school creamsicle Buccaneers, besides the orange home jersey. It's a red jersey, obviously. Kind of Boston College, but obviously we have white helmets and not the golden dome helmets that they rock as well. Kind of Washington, you know, football team, Washington Skins, Commanders, whatever you want to call them. Yeah, so it's kind of a mixture of all those teams into one. I was kind of thinking of a number scheme and a jersey scheme that I like. So their alternate jerseys are like the Denver Broncos numbers and then the two normal jerseys. I believe those are more like Tennessee Titan numbers. So yeah. That's that. That's how the jerseys look. These are our socks. I was thinking about maybe going with white shoes, but I just think black shoes are just more classy. Most guys rock black socks, black shoes. We do got the stripe on the top of the socks that typically match the pant leg that it goes with. So I'm liking the jerseys. I think that they're cool. Hopefully you think that they're cool as well. If you don't, go tell somebody who cares. Jimmy Johnson Jr. is the head coach of the squad. He runs a similar offense to his dad, so expect to see tight ends and fullbacks in the formations. There will be some three receiver sets, but do not expect to see us go four wide or anything like that too often. When it comes to the top 25, and I'm sorry, there's like this green thing going on. I have this cord to transfer the PS2 footage into 60 frames per second, but sometimes it's glitching. I think I figured it out. So halfway through the video, the quality should get better. Hopefully the quality is still good enough that you're not too mad at me. Now, our quarterbacks are not that good, so we will be on the recruiting trail to find our next quarterback. Jimmy Jones is our best guy at 68 overall, but this team is predicated on running the football. Mike McFadden, number 21 in the program. Hopefully he will be a beast on the field. He looks like it here. He looks like an absolute monster. Kind of reminds me of Fred Taylor at the University of Miami, who wore number 21, had a visor there. That's the kind of look I was going for, and I think we achieved that. Owens, 78 overall, 86 overall speed. We got two backers with 84 overall speed. Our best player, offense or defense, is this fullback, Brian Johnson, at 99 overall, 74 speed. He will be getting carries. He will not just be a blocking fullback like Moose Johnson for the most part was, but Moose did get some carries from time to time. Brian Banks, he's our Michael Irvin. He's our best receiver. Brent Samuel, he is our Novacek, if you will. Brent Thompson is one of our best offensive linemen at 82 overall. Tom Scott, 84 overall right guard. He is another good offensive lineman. I think he's tied for the best with our center. No, actually, he is the best, as our center also comes in at 82 overall. D lineman, Wendell Johnson off of the edge. I think he could be a monster at 82 overall. Tom Hurd at D tackle is 82 overall. Alvarez, 76 overall. And then when it comes to our linebackers, we have three really good left outside linebackers. So Allen will be our inside backer when we go 3-4. And then Woods, he will get some playing time. And of course, Smith will get some playing time, or our two main outside backers. And then Richard, he is our main middle linebacker at 72 overall. When it comes to our cornerbacks, Darius Moore, 84 overall with 87 speed. Diggs is his running mate with 84 overall speed. Sean Nelson is a redshirt junior with 80. He's an 80 overall athlete with an 84 overall speed and 80 overall Strong safety is Jacob Porter. So, Smith, he will be our starting right outside linebacker, and I think he is going to be a goon for us. So, a lot of under center stuff. Jimmy, they did go shotgun from time to time with the Miami Dolphins, with the University of Miami when he was there, and, of course, with the Dallas Cowboys. But for the most part, it's under center, and that's what his son, Jimmy Johnson Jr., would like to run as well. So, we will redshirt a couple of guys. Not all the guys, because a lot of these guys are redshirted already. So Kyle Ware, he's going to get the redshirt business. Was thinking about redshirting Bird, but then I was like, we're going to revamp this receiving corps. So I was like, I want these guys who I don't think have a future just to get through the program as fast as possible. Hopefully you leave with a good education and a great experience, and maybe we can win some championships here, and that would be a good look. Simpson, though, he will get redshirted. Our best center will not. Brooks at left end, 65 overall. He will get redshirted as a freshman at 6'5", 251. I think the sky's the limit for him. And then we got Davidson at right outside backer. He's a junior, so I'm like, you know what? We're just going to let you ride it out. Rocking that 56. Hopefully you can play like a Lawrence Taylor. And then Richard, he could get redshirted as a sophomore, and I could move one of those outside linebackers into our main middle linebacker spot, but I don't want to do that, so that's not going to happen. And then those are the rest of the guys, and nobody else will be getting redshirted. Our first game will be versus Cornell. The strength of schedule is a C+. We will be taking on Illinois on the road in week number 3. Then we got Kentucky, Iowa State, Purdue, Maryland, TCU, Clemson, Air Force, Harvard, Notre Dame, and then we have a bye, and then we're going to be taking on Navy because we took out Army. Now, the reason why the schedule is like this and it's not just all cupcakes, because with Grambling State, we did not have any televised games. And then when it came to recruiting, we had no points to dive into recruiting. So I'm thinking it's tied together. So I'm thinking that you have to play some teams that you might get your teeth kicked in at, just so you can recruit in the offseason. That's what I'm thinking. I have not verified that. I did not read no forms. That's just what I'm thinking. So Cornell, expect to get beat down. The rest of the schedule, it should be close games. I don't know how they're going to turn out, but let's get into it. We got games 1-4 today. Let's run the ball. There goes Brian Johnson. He works his way upfield. That is a great run for our fullback. They're going to start calling him Moose. Now, Jones, those that thing. Samuel, he has it. That's going to be a catch for a first down. Move those chains. First and goal from the 2-yard line. McFadden up the gut. Touchdown. And the first touchdown in Great Barracudas history goes to Mike McFadden, who is a freshman. So we could see him run the ball for us a lot. And hopefully that is the case. And then look at this hit. That is Aaron Smith, rocking number 91. Like, my goodness, he came through with mean intentions. Third down and 7 now. This pass, thrown deep down that right sideline, will be broken up. And they got to punt this one away. And McFadden is back there. And he got a mean block right there. I believe that was Allen, number 42. And there goes McFadden, number 21, to the C in North D.C. So 14-0 is now the score. They can go with the toss play. That's not going to work. Okay, that's Porter. Strong safety coming up strong. You feel me? This pass will be never thrown. Never thrown. Wendell Johnson off of the edge, just powering through traffic, says, get off me with the swim move, gets to the quarterback and says, how you like me now? Jones to the left side, looking for Brian Banks. He makes the dive and catch, and that will move the chains. Now it's first down and 10 from the 30-yard line. Give that thing to Johnson, who was loose, to the 20. He's going to try to fight through traffic, and he does. This man's legs never stop turning. He is an absolute animal out there. Now we're going to throw this one to McFadden on third down. Breaks one guy's ankles and he fumbles. But Thompson is there for the recovery. So, we got to set up for a field goal. The kick is up and the kick is good. And we're up 17-0. That pass will be caught. And that's going to result in a first down, but roughing the passer. So it will be a first down. They were short, actually. But roughing the passer will give them an automatic first down. And their quarterback is hurt. And it was Aaron Smith, number 91. He ain't playing. This guy, he has a chance to start as a senior. All these guys obviously transferred in. So these guys are just happy to be on the football field. And he's like, I got mean intentions for everybody. Okay, I got 12 games left. Hopefully a bowl game. 13 games left. Who knows if I'm going to play professional ball. I just want to play some good old football before my career is done, he's saying. That pass will be caught. And their backup quarterback coming in throwing nothing but heat-seeking missiles. So Cornell, they get on the board, and they're down by 10. Banks from his own 5-yard line to the 20, and he's loose. To the 40. He's going to get a block right there from McFadden, and he is gone. See you later. touchdown, and now this guy's hurt. It's turned into a body bag game. The Barracudas, they don't play. The great Barracudas, let me get it straight. The great Barracudas of North D.C. are out here to let everybody know that we are the real deal, Holyfield. You feel me? Okay, they go with a little quarterback or halfback pass to the quarterback, and yeah, knock you out. Hey, don't you ever put your quarterback in harm's way again versus the North. You feel me? Aaron Smith, you better calm down. I don't know if you can get a fine in college with all these NFL deals. They're about to start going after your pockets. That pass, it will be caught. It will be dropped. It will be incomplete. And then get to the intended receiver. Dixon off the edge, applying the pressure. And now it's going to be second down and five as we take over. Give it to Owens, our second string running back with 86 overall speed. And I think his acceleration is up there because he seems faster than fast. He gets upfield again. Got a mean block by the Brian Bros. Brian Banks and Brian Johnson with big blocks, and that's going to lead to a touchdown, 63-yard variety. So we can't be stopped right now, but let's take this for a grain of salt. It is what it is. It is Cornell. And I was taking the chance as we head to the second half that because it's that 0 week, that is week one or whatever you want to call it in college football, that it will still be on TV, and they're like, nah. This game will not be on TV. Not this one. I was hoping that it would be, but it wasn't. And look at Brian Johnson fighting for every inch. I love it. Gonna run the ball with McFadden to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown! And that's what the doctor ordered for Mr. McFadden. They're gonna throw this one deep in this pass. Give me that Yahoo! Zay. Alright, I said give me that give me that user interception. We got this thing on back the other way. Now McFadden is loose to the 40, to the 30, crosses the 20, headed to the goal line, and pushed out of bounds at the 1 yard line. First and goal, give it to Brian Johnson. Moose up the gut. Should I be saying Moose? And should we have so many Cowboys references for Washington Dynasty? Maybe not. I apologize. I'm really sorry from the bottom of my heart. Anyways, Jones looking downfield after that interception. Gonna throw this one. And look at the moss job by Banks. I'm loving that big time catch right there. And I think on this field, as we throw a pick, that these uniforms look fantastic. I don't know if it's like the brightness of the green. I don't know what it is. But I love these unis. When we get some pressure right there, we force them into a three and out. So these uniforms, hopefully we can see in a bowl game near you. As Johnson makes the catch and BJ has himself a first down to end the fourth quarter. The third quarter, I'm getting ahead of myself. Even though this game is already over, maybe I'm hoping that it ends the same way as, oh my goodness, running like an absolute moose. Have you seen mooses in the wild? Them things are some big, powerful animals. They ain't afraid to chase off a bear, but also not afraid to, you know, get eaten by a bear either. Anyways, Allen, he makes the pick right there. We take over, already up by a King's Ransom. Spin move by Owens, falls forward for a first down. We get inside the five. Owens crosses the goal line. Touchdown! And 59-7 is the score. And then that pass is intercepted by Davidson, the junior, that we did not side to redshirt. He has an interception. The cheerleaders are happy. And we win game number one. So, our man, Jimmy Jones, decent day, but one touch, one interceptions, no touchdowns. That's not how you want to start off your career with the North D.C. Great Barracudas. And that's not how I want to start things off because, again, getting a quarterback in here is going to be priority number one. Will that quarterback start day one if he is the better overall? I'm not sure because composure is a thing in this game, and composure is tied to how old you are, basically. If you're a junior, if you're a senior, redshirt, senior, all that plays into that. And if you have composure, you're a better quarterback. Now, if you look to the right of your screen, everybody coming to this school will have field awareness up to an A or a B, depending on how athletic they are, how well I think they can develop, all right? So far, it's all A's. Then Huff, receiver, he has a B. And then if we go down some more, Sullivan has an A minus. Stuckey has a B as well, but Stuckey is 6'5" and runs a 4.2. So him having B awareness is just fine, and B awareness is actually not bad at all. So we simulate a week, that week two where we had a bye, and these are the guys I'm going to go after. We have Lewis, inside linebacker. He's from Virginia, and North D.C. is on top of Ohio State. This quarterback is on, he has us on top of USC. He's from Hawaii. Greg Freeman, I think he could be a beast. Look at those numbers. Absolutely phenomenal. Chris Whitlock, He has us below USC and Cal, and I believe it was Nevada as well. Chase from Texas, looking at Texas, which I can't be mad at. He's also looking at Texas A&M. We're right in between those two schools. And then when it comes to Brian Reed, he has us right under Ohio State. So I think recruiting is going pretty well so far. When it comes to offseason recruiting, I think I may scout guys. I hardly ever scout guys. I just recruit them. Scouting does take up some points, but I'm thinking about utilizing some points to scout some guys because I don't want any more knuckleheads in my dynasties. I want guys who are smart, who are disciplined, who will not get suspended. Okay, that's what I'm looking for. So let's take on the Fighting Illini. This is, I believe, their home opener. I could be wrong, but I believe this is their home opener. So let's spoil their little homecoming, if you will, as McFadden works his way up to the 30-yard line. Our formation, going to run the ball to the right side, and I think the Fighting Illini have a little bit more fight than Cornell does. But there goes McFadden. He's like, hush your mouth, coach. We got this. That's going to be a nice carry right there. Jones looking downfield, and that pass will be intercepted. And Hansen works his way into North D.C. territory. So definitely not the start to the drive that we wanted. And then we get a sack, though. That's Woods, number 10 in the program, playing that middle linebacker spot, outside linebacker spot. And then we force him to cut back, but that doesn't matter as Stone goes untouched to the crib. Now, I did slightly overrun the play, but I was hoping to make the play in the backfield or force him to cut back. We did the latter, and it did not work out. So 7-0 is now the score. We're going to run this thing up that gut. Good blocking right there, and that's going to result in a first down. Second down and 8. Now we're going to run the ball again, and we turn the corner just to get met by a good tackler. So 3rd down and 5. Jones rolling right. Don't want to make a mistake, so let's throw that ball away, punt the ball away, and hopefully our defense can get a stop today. We get some pressure, but throw it to Jacobs. That pass is caught on his knees. 1st down and 10. Miller. He has the football. He's going to step up in the pocket, throw this one deep, and that pass will be intercepted by Moore. Number 20 out there could be shut down for real, like Jalen Ramsey before he went to number 5. You feel me? Owens up the gut. That's going to be a first down. Jones dropping back. When your left tackle and right tackle get pancaked, you know you're in some trouble. But Falk makes the catch on his knees. McFadden goes backwards, too, on that play. 3rd down and 7 now. Jones looking. And he's going to get dragged down behind the line of scrimmage. And now he's shaking up. And we could be in some serious trouble with our backup quarterbacks. Because all of our quarterbacks are in the 60s. But we do get a Yahoo Zayher. So our defense coming through when we need him too. But then we fumble. But we do recover. All right. So we do get the stop. We made the play. Sitting right there in the middle. They throw it to my boy rocking 47. And that is a problem. Because 47s, they're dangerous. Kind of like an AK. You know what I'm saying? So let's get back to the action. 2nd down and 10. Bell under some pressure. And Bell lets it fly. And we can't bring it in. But Harris does. And he plays for the lineup. So not what we wanted to see or do. And then Stone able to wiggle through traffic for a first down. From the 25-yard line, they give it to Jones. And Jones is loose. Jones to the 40, to the 50. He's in the enemy territory. And he's going to cross the goal line. Give him 6. So we have 17 seconds to try to score before the half is up. We throw this one. That pass caught by Banks. He can't quite get out of bounds. So we burn our first timeout. No, our second timeout. So we have 1 timeout left. Bell's going to roll to the right side, throw it to Falk. He hauls it in, but not out of bounds. So we burn our last timeout. 5 seconds on the clock, time for a Hail Mary. We throw it. It doesn't even get to the 10-yard line. And we're going to try it again, though, because there's 1 second left on the clock. And Bell steps up, throws this one a little bit deeper, not quite to the end zone. It's tipped into the end zone, but it will fall incomplete. So to start the second half on defense, our offense has less than 100 total yards. So that's kind of the day it's been. But we can stop this team. We just got to keep doing it. Do we have enough endurance to stop them again? Stone up the gut. He's like, check your endurance at the door. 20, 10, 5. Give him 6. So the line just continue to ground and pound us. They're like, you're supposed to be Smash Mouth. No, we are the real Smash Mouth guys on the team. We're going to, or on the field, I should say. We're going to run the ball to McFadden right there. Picks up a decent game. That's our first completion on 3rd down that results in a 1st down. So it's our first 3rd down conversion. Bell throws it, and that's a great play by Lane. It was zone coverage, but it looked like he was playing man until he peeled off of that one guy and got his hands on the football. And now Stone is weaving through traffic. and he's going to fall forward for a first down. They're going to give it to him again, and I mean, why not when he can do stuff like that? He finally gets brought down after he has a first down. They run the ball with Stone again, and he breaks another tackle, and that's going to be a first down. I mean, a touchdown. What am I talking about? That's a touchdown. We're down 28 to nothing. I wish it was just a first down. So Green throws that thing to the right side, and that pass will hit the grass, and that's going to bring up fourth down. And we put the football away. Miller has it, rolls left, throws it deep, and that pass will be caught by Jacobs. And this thing appears to be over. It's 35-0, but we're going to keep fighting because we're great Barracudas. And I heard that they hunt in packs, and that they're aggressive, and that they're not afraid to put the dukes up. That's what I've heard. I don't know. Now Green, looking downfield, and Green's going to get brought down. Green is the more athletic of our quarterbacks, so you will expect to see him throughout the series, at least in his freshman season, because, again, he's athletic. So we get the forced fumble there. We recover that thing, so it's going to be first down and 10. Jones going to look to the left side, lets it fly, caught by Banks, and here we go. But we're going up against their second unit, so all this really means nothing. Jones is back in the game, though, healthy, and that's what I want to see. And then we fumble, and I'm like, how is this their ball? He kicked it out of bounds, rugby style. Yes, you kicked the ball in rugby, in case you didn't know. But look at this. Like, it didn't even go out the back. Like, it didn't even, like, how? How is that their ball at the 20-yard line? And it is, and that's their ball game, and that sucks. We lose 35-0. Not how you want to start off your career on the road. But again, we're not just going to play the weakest schedule because I need some games to be on TV. So again, that we can recruit some better players so we're not in the dog days forever with this squad. And I do think we have some talent. We just got to get this running game more consistent. And we can't get down. When we get down, we kind of have to abandon the run game because we're only playing on 4-minute quarters. I will bump it up to 5 before these first 3 games. I kind of want to get through it. And then the fourth game will be on 5, and the rest of the series should be on 5-minute quarters. I know somebody out there is going, who plays a franchise or a dynasty on 5-minute quarters? I do, okay? I do, okay? That's who, because I make content for y'all to watch, and sometimes sitting there for like an hour and a half trying to record one game when you're trying to put multiple games in a video is not the spirit. Got things to do now. Lewis, he's on top with 400 yards rushing. He also has 5 touchdowns. Carlos Dawson, I realize that that's Calhoun from my Coach Dawkins series on my Coach Dawkins channel in the Detroit Lions, with the Detroit Lions. He's actually a beast. In college, he was at Wisconsin. He was. He was absolutely freaking good. Anyways, though, back to this. Our guy, and I do mean this, we have somebody that's on top. Our guy, Nelson, has the most interceptions in college football at 2. So he probably will lose that because I can't see him getting any more than 2. But hey, it is what it is. Now we're going to be taking on Kentucky. Their quarterback, Young, has 732 yards passing, I believe, in 2 games. Pretty impressive. So we are the home team. This game is on national television. Or maybe regional television. But it is what it is. It's still on TV. We get those ad revenue dollars. And that's what I need in my life. McFadden got grabbed by the face mask. So that will make it an automatic first down, even though it already was a first down. So tack on 15 more yards to the end of that run. McFadden to the outside. He's going to cross the 35, the 45. We're going another way. To 45. He crosses that, and it's going to be a decent game. Going to fire this one towards the end zone. Broken up. So now it's going to be 3rd down and 3 now from the 33-yard line. And we're going to run this one up that I got with McFadden. And he's going to have himself a first down from the 17-yard line. Give it to him again. Good blocking on the outside. And he's going to take it to the crib. And maybe we play a lot better at home than on the road. Just maybe. I'm not sure. Just maybe. So, 7-0 is the score. Young has the football. Throws it and give me that user interception. We got this thing going back the other way. So, 7-0 is the score. We got the football right back. Jones gonna roll to the left side. Set his feet. Throws it to Brown. And the big body receiver makes the play. First and goal from the 6-yard line. Going to Banks. Touchdown pass. And I believe that's touchdown pass number 1. And it couldn't have come at a better time. It really couldn't have. Young going to hand that thing up to Watson. Watson up the gut for a decent game. 2nd down 3. Give it to Watson again. No, it's Galloway in the backfield. Now, and Galloway, he gets some running room. And he's going to have a first down. 2nd down and 9 from the 44-yard line. Young has the football. He's going to throw this one to the right side. That pass caught by Alexander. Nice catch. The football went over his head, but he just grabbed that one and brought it back down to his body. That pass falls incomplete. Holding. It's on third down, so we're going to decline it, and they're going to put the ball on fourth down. We give the ball to McFadden. He's going to work his way upfield, and that should be enough for a gain of seven because we did not get a first down. Give it to 23 on second down and three, and that's not going to work out. So we lose a yard. Third down and four now. Jones looking, passing it. Banks makes the catch. Put your money in Banks. Second down and seven. Going to give that thing to Johnson. Johnson running hard, breaking all kinds of tackles. That's exactly what a fullback is supposed to do. At some point, football will go back to a fullback. I'm telling you it will. Somebody's going to want to just power these nickel defenses and be like, yo, tackle these big boys in the backfield. One day it will, mark my words. Second down and four, we're going to run that thing with McFadden to the 30. Has a first down, spin move at the 25. And brought down at the 20-yard line. Nice run by our freshman. Give it to him again. Has green grass in front of him. Gets down to the 5-yard line. Grabbed by the face mask. And it will be a personal foul. Half the distance to the goal. From the 2-yard line now, McFadden breaks a tackle. And that's a touchdown. McFadden, have yourself a day. Great Barracudas. Have yourself a day. 21-0. But we've never been in a situation before. We can't get too complacent. As we get a sack right there, I believe that is Hurd. Number 96, big deep tackle. Look at the spin move, like he Dwight Freeney or somebody. But they work it back down to third down and six. Young throws this one, and that pass caught by Ogletree. They said he got that big size 17 inbounds. Young fires it to Watson, and that pass will be caught for a first down in their inside Great Barracudas territory. Out of the gun. Young throws it, has a man open. That's Alexander, gets brought down by Porter, and he has another first down. Third down and 10. They fake the run. They throw it deep. That pass caught by Marky Mark. This first down's for everybody. The football's going all over the field. They're going to throw this one to the right side. Caught by Mark again for a first down. So it's first and goal from the 6. 5 seconds on the clock. They throw it to Mark. Touchdown, Kentucky. And they're going to cut the lead down to 14. So that will do it for the first half of play. 21-7 to score. To get the football right back. I believe they have momentum on their side after a drive like that to end the first half. Alexander makes a catch there. They go with a 3 tight end set. Galloway gets loose. And Galloway will have a first down. So from the 49ers, first down and 10. Young going to slide right. Throws this one deep. Mark has a step and he hauls it in over Moore. And that's going to be a big chunk play in the first down. Young. Under some pressure, slides left, throws it, and it's going to be caught. Touchdown, Kentucky, as Webb scores it for the passing attack of the Kentucky Wildcat. So now lead is just a 7.1 for the Great Barracudas. Jones throws that thing to Samuels, and he cannot hang on to that one. Third down and 9, Jones going to roll to the left side, looking for Samuel downfield, and Douglas jumps like Jumpman. Pick 6, and Kentucky has tied this thing up at 21-all. So just when you thought you had your second blowout victory, Kentucky comes screaming back like, no, wait, hold your horses. That pass dropped by Banks, and Jimmy Jones is now 3 of 7. We'll run the ball with Johnson, and this is kind of a sucker play, sucker move, but we just want to just pump the ball away and have nothing crazy happen. They run the ball with Galloway. He gets brought down by Wilson. Third down and 8 now. We send a blitz, not going to quite get there, but we do force a off-target pass. So we force a 3 and out. Johnson up the gut. Dice run and a first down for our big fullback. Last play of the third quarter. Give it to Johnson and we're going backwards. And now it's 21-21, fourth quarter. Can we come back or can we win? Can we bounce back? Looking for Brown. That pass caught right in the middle of the field. And that will be our first down for the Great Barracudas. So we're in Kentucky territory. Going to run the ball with Owens. He's weaving through traffic and he will have a gain of 8. From the 31 now, second down and 2. Give it to Owens again. Falls forward for a first down. And the Great Barracudas up to the 27-yard line. Johnson with the carry. Up to the 15-yard line. Move those chains. Third down and 5. Jones looking. Throws it underneath. Caught by Falk. Hoping he could break a tackle. He cannot. We got to settle for a field goal. Kick is up and the kick is good. So 24-21 is now the score. Young, he's going to drop back. Young going to fire that thing. Caught by Mark. To the 40 he runs. And that's going to result in the first down to the 41 they go. Second down and 5. Young has the football. Throws it to Joseph. He hauls it in and everybody. Mark, Joseph, where's John and Matthew and Peter and Paul? Where you need them? Alexander, he makes the catch right there, and that's going to result in the first down. Second down and four. Young fires that thing. Caught by Webb, and Webb is going to have a first down as well. 15 seconds on the clock. They throw it towards the end zone. Caught by Galloway. Touchdown, Kentucky. And the Wildcats take the lead for the first time today. 13 seconds on the clock. Jones rolling right. Held the ball too long. He's going to get sacked. We have two timeouts left. 8 seconds on the clock. Jones going to roll left. He's going to set his feet. Throws it deep. Caught by Banks. Got to call a timeout with 2 seconds on the clock. Can we heave it downfield from here? Hopefully we can. We're going to throw this one as far as we can. Gets to the 20-yard line and it will fall incomplete. And we lose after being up 21-0. 28-24 is the final. So we did score a touchdown through the air, our first one in great Barracudas history. Clap it up, clap it up, clap it up. But we do lose to Kentucky. And that's a game that we possibly should have won. It was at home. And you only have, well, the way I do it, and I think in most college football programs, if you do 12 games, you get 7 at home and 5 on the road. For this, what I've done is just split it up 6-6. Losing at home is not going to be a good option because now we're going to have to win at least one on the road. And the more that we lose at home, the more we got to win on the road. And it's never easy winning on the road because composure, again, is a thing when you have younger guys, not experienced guys. That inexperience will come through. So Florida beat number 2 Tennessee. Tennessee is now number 7. Florida's up to number 3. Florida State lost to Boston College. They go from number 4 to outside the top 10. Alabama was ranked number 8. They lost to South Carolina. Now they go to number 15. And then you got Fresno State up in the top 20. TCU, they move up as well. Miami, they lost to Clemson. They go from number 10 to at number 24. And we have to suspend our kicker of all people. Now looking at this, if that was a real thing, one, I don't think that's going to go to the Washington Post. Well, when Washington, I just say Washington Post. That's a kicker missing a workout. I would give him some type of punishment, but it wouldn't be suspending him because I don't think that's like, it's a kicker. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I should suspend him, and that's why I disciplined him in the game. But in real life, I don't know. Anyways, we're going to be taking on Iowa State. Iowa State finds himself in the top 25, and Miles, that is a great name, works his way up to the left side for a good kick return up to the 26-yard line. Anderson throws that thing. That pass caught by a quarter. 50, 40, the fullback rumbling to the 20, running inside the 10 to 5, touchdown Iowa State. And the Cyclones put us in a tornado on that first play. We're going to run the ball with McFadden. Nice carry right there. Able to fall forward. That's going to be a gain of 6. Second down and 4. Give it to McFadden again. Gets upfield. And that's going to result in a first down by the hairs of a chin chin chin. Okay, it was not that serious. Jones looking downfield. That pass. I believe that hit my man in the helmet. You got to make that catch for me. Third down and 9. Jones. Slides right, throws it. That pass caught by Falk, and I'm liking Falk. I am really liking Falk. He's just like that classic slot receiver. He can just do so many good things for us. McFadden up the gut, picks up the first down. Second down and 10, play fake. Jones fires that thing. Bobbled and caught by Johnson. He gets brought down inside the 15. So third down and 4 from the 14-yard line. Jones gonna roll left, throws it to the back of the end zone. Caught by Falk. Touchdown, great Barracudas, and we're not going down without a fight. This is our home field. We know number 25 is here. We don't care. We don't care, Iowa State. We don't care. And I'm a Niner fan. I love me some Brock Purdy. Who doesn't love Brock Purdy? We all love Brock Purdy, but not today. Okay, not today. Anderson gets upfield, and Anderson running like he's Seneca Wallace or somebody. First down and 10 to go to play fake. Anderson has all day in the pocket. All my D linemen got pancaked on that play, and Carter has another catch, and it's going to be a first down. They go up the gut with Smith, breaking all kinds of tackles. And Smith to the 40. Smith inside the 30. Still on his feet, and he gets inside the 20-yard line. And it's going to be now from the 8-yard line, 30 inches to get to Smith again. And he's able to get through the lane for a touchdown. That is a big boy running that football like that. McFadden to the 30. Breaks a man's ankles. Works his way up past the 35-yard line and has a first down. Second down and 8 now. Jones going to roll left. Throws it. That pass caught by Brown yet again. He's everywhere you want him to be. Start of the second quarter. Won't give that thing to Johnson up the gut. Stop just shy of the first down marker. Third and 1. Give it to him again. He will have the first down. Gets brought down by the collar. move those chains. Give it to him a third straight time, and we go backwards on second down and 10. So now it's going to be third down. We're a perfect 3-for-3. Can we make a 4-for-4? Can we make a 4-for-4? No. Fumble. And they are going to recover it. Man got the fumble recovery. Walker got the sack and the forced fumble. And Iowa State got the football. That pass caught by Lewis in double coverage. Took a nasty hit, but it does not matter. Second down and 3. They give the ball to Smith. No, they fake it to Smith. They throw it, and that should have been a pick, but should have, would have, could have, never count. They don't. First and goal. They give it to Carter. Touchdown number 2. He has one through the air for his mama and one on the ground for his pappy. Now Green in the ball game to run the option. He gets upfield to pick up a first down. Second down and 11. Jones back in the ball game to let this one fly, and that pass caught by Brown, but just shy of the first down. So third down inch from 39. You're going to run this option. We pitch it to McFadden. Great execution, and he's loose, and he works his way inside Cyclone territory. Second down and 8. Jones has the football, drops back, throws a strike to Banks, and this is what the doctor told us to do. Get the football into your playmaker's hands. Let them do what they got to do. McFadden makes the catch and coverage, and that's going to result in the first down. The ball goes to Owens. Owens has it, and he works his way upfield for a gain of 6. So from the 10-yard line, second down and 4, we give it to Owens again, who goes backwards now. Third down and 7. Jones has it, rolls left, still rolling. Now he's going to keep it, and he gets tackled before he can pick up the first down. So we call a timeout with 1 second on the clock. The kick is up, and the kick is good, and we're down by 11, headed to that second half of play. So 21-10 is the score. We get the football first, start the second half. We got it in McFadden's hands. It gets away from one guy and then dragged down as he gets up to the 22-yard line. Now it's second down and 11. Jones throws this one over the middle. Out off of the hands of Samuel, and I want to use my tight end, but his hands are clearly all beat up for blocking for our guys. Green in. He's going to let it fly. Green completes the pass. Our option quarterback letting that thing fly to Falk, who is having himself a ball game. Second down and 5 now. We give that thing to Owens. Owens, he gets upfield, and Owens gets brought down after a gain of 9, and that's going to be a first down. Second down and 15. Jones throws it. That pass in the other hands of Banks. So now it's going to be third down. Jones going to roll right, looking for Brown, and he overthrows him. So we have to set up for a field goal, and the kick is up, and the kick is going to hit the upright and be no good. So our suspended kicker comes back into the second half, and he misses the kick. He should have been at practice, young man. First down and 10. Play fake. Anderson throws it. That pass going to be caught by Cook. And Cook works his way upfield for a first down. This Cyclones offense is starting to cook a little bit. Carter up the gut. That's going to be a first down, but holding, so bring it back. So first down and 19, a perfect time to back this defense up, or back this offense up even more. But they do what I said first. Back the defense up. Nice run by Anderson, and that's going to be a gain of around 17. Third down and 2. They go up their gut, and we are there with the stop. That's Hurd coming through. Big deep tackle. Fourth down and 1. Our formation, strength on strength. He goes up that gut and untouched. And when he goes strength on strength, we're going to see who's stronger. And right now, Iowa State, they're proving to be a little bit more stronger than us. Jones looking downfield to who? Falk comes open again. Another catch and another first down. 4 catches, 99 yards for the Falk man. Jones going to roll to the left side. Throws it to Banks. He makes the catch. He gets brought down fairly quickly, but he has a first down in his back pocket. Now Jones, under some pressure, he's going to roll to the right side. Throw this one deep downfield, caught by Falk, and that's going to result in another first down. Rolling out is Jones. He's going to set his feet. He throws it, caught by Banks. Got that 1 foot in bounds. We get the ball to Johnson. He has a first down, and then some. Dives for the goal line. Touchdown. And North D.C. gets across the goal line, puts 6 more up on the board, and now we are down 28-17. So we have to get a stop right here, right now. No ifs, ands, buts about it. Big block right there. Smith gets away, still on his feet. Breaks another tackle and crosses midfield as Nelson brings him down at the 49-yard line in North D.C. territory. Smith to the left side, brought down by Richard. And this defense needs some more of that. We need the first guy to make the stop from here on out. Smith gonna get brought down by Richard. I guess Richard's the only man up for that task, I'm guessing. Smith loose again. Smith to the 15, to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Cyclones. And that might make this one a little bit too hard to overcome. But Green gets loose, and Green, he fumbles, had a great run, but forgot the football. So our formation now for the Cyclones. Anderson, under some pressure, he goes down, but now Porter's shaking up, and that's not what we want to see. We do not want to see this turn into a body bag game. Let's stay healthy, please. Anderson drops back, throws it. Caught by Cook, but stopped before he can get to the first down marker. But 4th and 3, they're going to go for it. They're going to run the ball, and Smith has the first down, brought down by Nelson, and that clock continues to run. Minute 24 on the clock. They give the ball to Smith, brought down by Nelson, but in the end zone, touchdown, Iowa State. So we're up to midfield, and we go backwards. So now it's going to be 3rd down and 17 from our own 45-yard line, and Jones drops back and gets sacked again. And we're going to throw in the towel, and that is going to do it. 42-17 is the final in this one. So we start off our new dynasty, 1-3. Not the best start, but we're definitely a much better team. And these games are not impossible to win. We just got to execute a little bit better. But that's going to do it. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope that the rest of the day is the best today. To me again, my friends. Peace, love. Hot sauce.